Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude.
You have been warned.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Okay. Here's a thought. Don't tell if I'm right or wrong. Well, like, if you know the story, don't be like, yeah, that's exactly it. You nail on the head. So here's the thought. He's still writing. This doesn't exist. This is just a character. He's writing the world somehow. Like all the steps that he needs in order to beat the darkness, so that when he wakes up, somehow that affects. Oh, somehow, or maybe like this is a dream. Hey, Mondes. So, if it's a dream, he's still affected by the darkness, so he's writing a dream in a dream. So, the outside dream's affecting the inside dream where the darkness is at. If he can beat it in the inside dream, then the normal dream he can wake up from. Okay.
Marvelous, sir.
Not gonna lie, I had an easier time trying to figure out Inception than this.
Regrettable little outing.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
Not really.
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
It's called...
I invited her here.
Writer's
my
block.
My clinic is a place where...
Oh my god!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent.
Which would...
If you have business with Mr. Wade,
vaguely sound like it's voiced by Joe Pesci.
You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a meeting appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Okay, then don't...
Mr. Wake!
Wow.
Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
Don't know.
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you.
Easy there, boy.
Hi, dog.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay,
man,
sure.
That dog is,
What happened?
crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky.
See, I hate Max the dreams where you have, the falling dream. Leave him alone just yet. The forms on the desk Huey.
Curiously, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy? And his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week! And someone's got Alice! And everything's just-
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm. Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster.
Well, then come along with me.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this
later? Hey, Kevs.
No, this whole thing... Listen, you hit your head.
I can't have a running dream because I get out of my bed and I will run up and down the stairs. When I was younger, apparently I did it 46 times. And how I woke up is I missed the last step. yeah, that actually, it scared my mom. Because you can hear this just constantly up and down. Yeah, it's not fun. High school was really tiring in the morning. Sadly, it was a common occurrence. I can't tell if Barry's like a friend or not. I'm sorry, Huey.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
Poor dog.
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
I feel like everybody has, like, in this game, everyone has something to say. Everybody has something to say. Just everybody.
You're asking me to believe
that
you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds.
They're not that bad, you know. Three-course meals, lots of
healthy diet of pills.
Healthy attention.
You make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic.
And they no longer use the straitjackets unless you're really bad.
On homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on. I mean, okay. Maybe something weird happened to you. Okay.
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
He didn't say yes, and he didn't say no. My mom, when she was young, and you gotta understand, Night of the, like, Living Dead, the first one, the black and white one, that was, like, when that came out, that was really terrifying, because they were, like, kids, okay? That was, like, really scary, so I guess they went to a drive-in movie theater. If you don't know what that is, it's literally you have your car parked outside and you're watching a movie. Because I said that last time and like somebody's like, I don't know what that is. I've never seen that. But they were watching and my mom had gotten out, got some popcorn. She came back. Her older sister had her arm like sticking out the car window. So her sister walked around, snuck up, and because she had already seen the movie. So I guess as the second the zombie, like, jumped in and started gnawing on the person, my aunt at the time decided to gnaw on her older sister, which my Oldest aunt. Lost a tooth. So there you go. I don't know, like, Pat, the second you said that, it drew right back to that moment. I was like, huh. It's just crazy. That seems vaguely familiar.
Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI?
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her. This is not a goddamn debate, Barry. I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
He's dead. He's dead. Bless you. You're dead.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
I have no idea what deliverance is, but okay.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me. I'll bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth a 15% commission.
But you're making 15% off of him? Are you kidding me? This is gonna sound insane, but when I was younger, I really would love to have the ability to like the opportunity to be in the middle, the eye of a tornado. I always thought that was really cool, or like a hurricane. Because I saw Tornado with, it's the guy from, Aliens. God, I forget his name, but he's in quite a few things. Well, basically, my yeah, no, I know. It just basically after watching the movie Tornado, my idea of tornadoes was that there'd be like, if the tornado was large enough, there'd be a point inside that would be quote unquote safe for like a fraction of a second, and I thought that'd be kind of cool to experience. But you know, tough. Like, fat chance actually, you know, having it.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
No! Hey, at least you have the ability to wake yourself up. I love these little radio things. These are awesome.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No plan, really. Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it.
Okay, the dog with the spinning owl head, that would, yes, one, be really cool watching as a movie, but that'd be really disturbing.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution.
Oh, yeah, it's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a...
Hoot-hoot, motherfucker.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore.
Wait, there's somebody outside, guys. Take my time and enjoy. Oh, wow, I can actually turn the lights on in this place? No, cool. Catching, you know? Simple, but awesome. Almost every dream I can take control of. Unless it's a falling dream, usually my body will jerk in response to it because I get the weird sense of falling. And so, of course, my body jerks and kind of it makes me aware that I'm asleep. But the only dream that I haven't been able to, like, if I have it, I can't get out of it, is unless I wake up normally. Well, or startled. I must have way too many neurons misfiring, Rav. But admittedly, that does make sense. I can climb it, but I can't climb through it. Okay. But I can kick it. Nah. What's up, Null? That's the grim in the back here. I'm finding the... Scary stuff. I guess because I allow myself to be immersed when I'm playing games or when I watch movies. It's very seldom that I actually wake up screaming. Usually, if I do, you. Yeah, you can hear it. You can hear it.
Get your popcorn, guys. Get your popcorn.
He's inside, Agent. He's a weird one.
So, you're confessing to killing that guy, huh? Why?
Had it coming?
Yeah, but why would you do that? I mean, you're a nice guy. Normal. Took a kid to a soccer game. So how come at the game, you pick a guy and, quoting from the arresting officer's report here, assault the victim's head area repeatedly with the weapon of choice being a pair of bare fists. Wow, that sentence really flows, huh? Maybe you're not the literary type. Okay, so you mess him up. But why? Who was that guy? We couldn't ID him. Why would a guy like you do him like that?
I didn't like his face?
Well, you must have hated it, because you really went to town there. I mean, there's no way to tell what he looked like. No ID on him either.
That must be difficult.
But then we ran the fingerprints. Got a match. Your prints. Identical.
Huh. How about that?
Your son said you were wearing a white shirt when you took him to the game. But the white shirt is on the dead guy.
It's plenty red now.
You won't get away with this.
Do you really think that's in any way relevant to me? I had plenty of time to talk to my boy before the cops arrived, you know? He won't stop screaming, am I right? You think he's ever gonna be okay? I left my mark, believe me.
You bastard.
What? You gonna shoot me? What's the point? I'm going to prison. You got me.
I don't understand any of this.
And you never will. Don't worry. Maybe you'll see me again, Agent. Maybe.
Okay, I'm gonna throw this out there. I feel like each one of these Night Spring Twilight inspired shows are based off of what's going on with him. I needs to do the ketchup. Lots of ooh. Matt's just like, Hey, I'm being honest, brother.
The vision left me weak. This was no head injury.
Oh, gotta run. I have one superpower. Automatic dumbass.
I need a key to get in.
Back door? Okay, seriously, what the hell?
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened just the way it was on that page.
I found.
Came true.
It knew.
So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have.
Hey, Jeffrey!
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Hey, Queen, I have priorities, okay? Like, he's a writer. Coffee's like, caffeine's in his blood.
Shh, good boy.
Random jump. Good doggy. Just don't go evil on me, because I really don't want a Walking Dead Season 2 thing to happen, okay? I'm just gonna say it. Did not like that. Can I set the dog free? Wait, can I? Come here, buddy. Here, can I set you free? Let my people go? We're playing Alan Wake. I played this once before when it first came out back on the 360. I have almost no idea what this game's about anymore. Which is really good. That's the best way to play a game. Wait, is he missing? Ooh. Oh dear.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
Good. Need a hand? Oh, God. D&D all over again, I swear to God. You jump on one bar, like, to stop a bar fight, you jump on one table, hoping to have it brace your fall, and somehow you magically lose a hand. Yeah, it's cute. I had a shotgun. Had.
I was too late. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no
about another 50 on. Minutes. Whoa.
The ground was covered with oil patches that looked like liquid darkness.
I just need haunting my senses.
Where'd he go?
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Wait, where? Oh!
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Where's the...
is only permitted for those prisoners
who purchase a park license. Obey
the park ranger's instructions
at all times.
Rusty, no!
Never!
Every soldier in 100 yards!
Two bears and wolves! Never approach any other wildlife closer than
25 yards!
Pets must be leashed!
Yeah, at all times!
Never leave your pet
unattended!
We're gonna let him stay. Drugs? Yeah, totally. Totally. They are all just tripping on magical shadow drugs. See, this is the fun parks and recreation. The one that you guys never get to see in. Wait, was there anything... Man, Okay, I get it, Deerfest. But seriously, that is way too much ammo. Like, okay, Fee-fi-fo-fum, some motherfucker's gonna get my thumb. Cell phone's ringing.
What the hell was that? I saw from the window. I saw something.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy! Ow, be careful!
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone.
The demon deers. My luck, it's gonna be trees, dump trucks, trash bins, everything's fair game. Beer cans? Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. It gives you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Which could give you chocolate. Chocolate. Mmm.